After India's diplomatic strike on the Indus waters treaty, Pakistan is rattled. And look how Sartaj Aziz now says that India cannot abrogate the Indus waters treaty unilaterally.
And they are going to continue to rant about these things for times immemorial. In fact, they should be addressing the issue of terrorism. That should be their first priority.
Exactly.
To get basically to prevent isolation from the world community, in the sense that India is going all out now and using all options possible in a graded manner. We do not need to be excessively worried about what Pakistan reacts or what do they say, because they just don't know what they are saying and what they are doing. They're just going into a helter-skelter kind of a situation at the moment. I will go a step further now. If we are looking for the world to isolate Pakistan diplomatically, in my view, we should downgrade our diplomatic relations with Pakistan. Yes, that is very important.
All right, all right.
Sartaj Aziz never makes any sense anyway. So what he says has to be taken with a pinch of salt. The second thing is he can try and drag us to whichever court he wants to drag us. Ultimately, it's a question of power equations. And if supposing, well, yes, it is true that because the Indus Waters Treaty has in a sense been underwritten by the World Bank, there will be certain implications if India walks out of it unilaterally. And that is something we have to factor in if we intend to actually abrogate the treaty or even suspend it. But the point is that no treaty is sacrosanct in the world. Treaties are made and broken throughout the history. That is what has happened. And if you are not willing to take the heat, then you shouldn't stand in the kitchen. That is as far as the abrogation of the treaty is concerned. Now, there are other countries in the world which have blatantly and brazenly flouted the orders of international tribunals and international courts and haven't been any worse off for it. So I think in a very calculated manner, if India feels that it is in a position to go ahead with abrogation, then no reason why it should not do it. And if it feels that it probably needs more preparation to do this, then even if you are going to do this in a year or 2 years or 3 years' time, this should be on the anvil, and you can do it as and when required.
And
right from Parliament attack, Akshardham, Mumbai 26-11, Pathankot, and now Uri. Pakistan was relatively stable. They made some face-saving statements and got away. This time, we got Pakis really rattled. Look at their internal situation. Sindh, you got MQM and Altaf Hussain creating problems for them. Now you got Bukti on board with us. You have Fatah already creating problems for them. They, along with PTT, are a heady mixture. Prime Minister raised three issues of Balochis, POK, Gilgit, and Pakistan and Baltistan. Pakistan is now really rattled. Its international relations with the neighbors is disturbed, with Iran and now with Afghanistan. This time we have caught Pakistan on its wrong foot. My only advice is we must not let go of this jugular strangle we got over them. And most importantly, our Indian political parties, especially those in opposition, please stop supporting Pakis.
Yes.